Okay girls, so today's our topic is about aggregate functions in SQL. What are these aggregate functions? Aggregate functions are the functions where the values of multiple rows are grouped together as input. So it is going to group all the multiple values into a single row. When we use these aggregate functions with group or having class of select statement. So we have to use with group or having classes. So what are these aggregate functions? Aggregate functions are count, sum, average, minimum and maximum. First, what is count? The name itself says that it is going to count the number of records in a table. So in a table we are going to enter the rows, that is tuples. So it is going to calculate how many records are there in a table. Syntax count star. If you want we can use count in the parenthesis star, or if you want we can use count, we can write the column name. So if you use count star, it returns the total number of records in the table. It means it's not going to calculate on a single column. It is going to calculate, suppose in a student table I am going to enter 10 records, so it is going to print the 10. Count salary, so how many salaries are there, it's going to count and it's going to print the value. Example, select count star from student. So in a student table how many rows are there, it's going to print. Next is sum. It is going to calculate the sum of values. So all the in the columns, if I wrote sum in bracket, I'll write the column name. So in that column name, what are the values are there? All the values are summated, means added, and it's going to print the final value. See the example, select category ID, comma, sum units in stock from products group by category ID. So here I'm using group by class. So select, so I'm going to select category ID, comma, sum of, so there is two columns are there, category ID and unit stock. So unit stock, I'm going to add all the unit stock in the product table, from product table, group by category ID. So it's going to group all the category IDs and it's going to print the summation of units in stock in which table? Products table. Next, average. So it's going to calculate the average value. Suppose if I want to calculate all average marks of the students, I can write select average marks from student. Select average marks of student. So it's going to calculate the average marks of the student. Like that, I can going to calculate the minimum. So if you want to get the minimum value from the set of values, so I can write select min of marks from the table, that is table name you can write student, so that who got the minimum marks, it's going to print that value. Maximum, to get a maximum value in set of values. So if I want to get the maximum value from all the students, I can write select max of students from max of marks from students. So it's going to print the maximum marks from the student table. So count is going to calculate the number of rows in a table. Either I can use count star or I can use count, I can write the field name or attribute name. Sum is going to calculate the sum of values. Average is going to calculate the average value of the particular column. Minimum is going to print calculate the minimum value from the total table. Maximum is going to print the maximum value. So these are all the average functions in the SQL: count, sum, average, minimum and maximum. Note, we can use aggregate functions individual. If you want, we can use individual, like select count star from student, or select minimum marks from student, or select maximum marks from student, or select sum of marks from student. Like that, I can use individually. Or we can use distinct, only distinct values or all values. If I want, I can use the see here example, select count distinct or all roll number. If I want, I can use distinct, or if I want, I can use all. Select, if I use distinct, select count distinct roll number, or select count all roll number. Means if I use distinct, it is going to eliminate the duplicate value. So means it's going to, if any repeated values are there, it is going to repeat, it is not going to count that repeated values, only it is going to calculate it as a single value. All means duplicate values are also included. Suppose I have two names, Kalyani, Kalyani. So it is going to, if I write distinct, only one name is counted, Kalyani. So if I write all, so two times Kalyani is there, so it's going to count the two records. Okay, like that we can use distinct or all. If you by default all is used, so if you write distinct, it's going to calculate the distinct values. Next concept is subquery. What is this subquery? Query within the query is called subquery. Means a subquery is nested inside a large query. So till now we have written only single query, select star from student or insert into table name, or select star from student where roll number is equal to. Like that we have written only single query. Here we can write two queries. So a subquery may occur in select class, from class, or where class. So we can write select class, we can write where class, or we can write from class. A subquery can be nested inside a select, insert, update, or delete statement, or inside another query. So this subquery can be written in select statement, this subquery can be written in insert statement, this subquery can be written in update statement or delete statement. A subquery is added where class of another SQL statement. So this subquery can be added in another SQL statement also. In subqueries, we can use the comparison operators like less than or equal to, equal to, in any or all. We can use all these operations. It is also called as inner query or inner select. This subquery can be called as inner query or inner select. A statement containing subquery is also called as outer query or outer select. If you are writing in parenthesis, then we are calling it as inner query. Outside the parenthesis, we are writing is called as outer query or outer select. Inner query execute first, then outer query. First inner query will be executed, then after, by taking that result, it is going to calculate the outer query. The result of inner query are passed to first inner query will be executed. Whatever the result will be printed, according to that result, it is going to calculate the outer query. See the syntax here, select star from table where expression operator select star from table. See here, first I am writing first query, select star from table where I am writing an expression operator. Any expression you can write, equal to, less than, all, or you can write. And in parenthesis I am writing select star from table. Means select star, first select star from table is called a outer query. In parenthesis we are writing select star from table, this is called as inner query. So first this inner query will be executed. After this, the whatever the result is, that result is going to pass to this one, and according to that the outer query will be executed. See the example here, select star from customers where ID, select ID from customers where salary greater than user. Okay, so first inner query will be executed, select ID, so it's going to select an ID, which table, from customer table where salary greater than user. So whose salary greater than user is going to, or we can add salary greater than 5000 or 10000. So salary who got above 10000, his ID is printed, that ID is copied to this ID, outer ID. Suppose I am getting the ID as 201. So 201 is the output of the inner query. Now that 201 is going to add it to this outer query, select star from customers where ID is equal to 201. So according to this 201, so all the customers are printed. So this is the subquery. So what is subquery now? A query within the query is called as subquery. Means nested query is called as subquery. So we are writing two queries. One, which one is executed first? Inner query is executed first. Depending upon the inner query output, the outer output query is executed. Okay, so this is the concept of subquery. Thank you, guys. So I'm going to explain the TCL commands and remaining topics in the next session. Thank you.